Thank you very much. Actually, I prepared a whole presentation, slide presentation, which I'm not going to show you because I want to talk to you, not to present to you. And let's start with innovation. Innovation is a major engine of growth in Israel. Innovation is a very important part of our life. We have the highest expenditures on R&D as percentage of GDP in the world. We have the highest number of scientists per capita in Israel. We have a very high number of patents per capita in all areas, in medical devices, number one. And we have the number one number of biotech companies per capita. We are a startup nation. And as a startup nation, you have to know that over 6% of our population are entrepreneurs. These are normally young guys who are not satisfied with anything and they want to achieve something more and more and more, and therefore they are innovative and they create startup companies. We create every year over 1,000 startup companies, of which 100 companies are in the life science field. And most of them, of course, in the medical devices. So therefore, innovation for us is important, and we, apparently we are very good in innovation. The challenge that we have, I'm talking about now China-Israel relationship, the challenge that we have is that most of these innovator entrepreneurs, they direct their invention and products towards solutions toward solving problems that exist in the Western countries. Because in the Western countries, if you go to the U.S., most of them to the U.S., because in the U.S., first of all, it's the largest market so far. Maybe China will grow beyond it, but right now it's the largest market. Secondly, information, everything is transparent. If you want to know something about the market, you push the Google, you get it. If you want to know something about competition, you push the Google, you get it. If you want to know something about prices, you push the Google, you get it. When you go to China, it's not a transparent economy. So people don't get, it's not easy for them to get the information. And the challenge and the market failure that we have in the relationship between China and Israel is that in China, there is a major place for Israeli innovation. And China can be a major market for Israeli innovation. The question is how Israeli innovators understand the problems, the issues, the needs of the Chinese in order to develop products which are specific for the Chinese market. And this is not easy, because in order to understand it, we have to spend more time there, and the Chinese have to spend more time here, you know. If we don't talk to each other, we will not find out what are really the needs in China. And so this is one challenge. And I will speak a little bit about it later. And the other challenge is the challenge of understanding for Israelis how to do business in China. We don't know how to do business in China. I can tell you that in 2005, when I was the CEO of Teva, I bought the first biotech company in China. Then I bought a distribution company in China. Then I built up an API company in China. And since then, I'm trying to introduce to China products. I have now a number of medical device companies which are focusing on China, and I'm still learning. I still don't know how to do business in China. And my conclusion is that it's not like in the West, you know, you go to a distributor, you know, you're Israelis, you go to a distributor and you expect the distributor to come and make a market for you. We have to find strategic alliances there. I'm talking to the Israelis, and I'm talking also to the Chinese. You have to create true partnerships with Israelis. And the this partnership should decide what is the best way to introduce the product to the market, how to do it, with whom to do it, very important, with whom to do it, and so on and so forth. And the special needs that exist in China are not always known to the Israeli community. And I give you just a few examples. For example, the healthcare economy is such in China that it's quite challenging to deal continuously with safety issues of medical treatments in rural areas. It's not easy because the people are not coming back to the doctor. The doctor is not always available to them. They can't go back to the hospital every day like they try to do it in the West. And therefore, the importance of managing safety issues is not less important than the efficacy of drug. If you ask me what is better, a very efficacious drug with with major safety issues, or a less effective drug with much less safety issues, the second one is the right one for China. And there are many diseases which are controlled in the West and not controlled in China. For example, take cervical cancer. Cervical cancer in the West is controlled. It's really controlled. But in China, it's one of the major cancer killer of women. There are over 30,000 deaths of cervical cancer in China. And how do you treat it? How do you diagnose it? And the diagnosis is very important because early treatment can really cure the disease. So this is a major challenge. So, and it's not enough to come with a solution. My company came here with the solution. The problem is to find out the right partners that can do that can do it together with you and introduce it to the market and actually meet the needs of the Chinese. And the same goes for other diseases. You have a very high rate of glaucoma and a few other diseases. And the more these problems will be exposed to the Israeli innovators, you know, the more solutions we can offer to the Chinese. But we have also to understand and to develop together with you the right partnerships that will allow us to go into the Chinese market. And I think this is a huge opportunity for both sides, and I think that both sides have to make a real effort and be patient with each other. It's not easy to be patient with each other, trying to really develop ventures which will be mutually beneficial and will be on scale, which is a really very large scale. So I wish you all a very productive visit here, and try to remember a few of the things that I was trying to raise here. Thank you very much.